friends, Vaishali Khanwala here, design team member of Itsibitsi, and today on the channel I would be sharing a video tutorial of festive platter. This platter is keeping in mind the different festivals that would be coming and celebrated here in India. And this platter is decoupaged using the new designs of the decoupage papers. Little Birdie, that is the Itsibitsi's manufacturing brand, has recently launched new designs in the decoupage papers. Let me take you through them first. This particular design that you see on the screen now has a beautiful watercolor effect, beautiful flowers in watercolor effect. Now this kind of a packaging that they have two designs in each packet, two designs with two papers of each design. So you have four papers in the packet. And this kind of a packaging helps you to make coordinated sets like trays, coasters, tissue box. So all can be made in a coordinated way. Even bigger projects can be covered when you have multiple designs in a packet. Now this particular design has these lovely flowers which have a border kind of a layout. If you see, you mean you can cut borders out of it for your project. And along with the border layout, you will see there's some nice postal stamps and things like that on it, which makes it complete by itself. So in this way, you can play around with these papers in different ways. Now, these prints which are there are very beautiful, like the next one, which is having a lovely mason jar and flowers in it. Now, and on the other print here is a background overall floral print. Now, these papers, let me talk to you about the thickness of the papers, which is very important in decoupage. They are 70 GSM papers, and that is, it is thinner as compared to a scrapbooking paper, which would be around 250 GSM. Now, the advantage of that, you can fussy cut elements out of it, and those fussy cut elements, when adhered on any surface, will not pop out. That in that sense, you can easily merge them with the background, and then that is what the essence of decoupage is. And apart from that, the thickness, when it is 70 GSM, it can easily be used on curved surfaces. It will easily turn around on the curved surface, or even if you have any undulated surface with any kind of a corrugations, you can use. Now here there are various elements that you can see on the screen, and one background as well. So you could make, like, you know, again a coordinated set, like a stationery set with different magnets or notebook. You can cut elements out of it, pen stand, and then the overall print can be used for name boards or any such project like that also. Now this is another beautiful design, one of my favorite. It is very rare to get a black background in decoupage papers, and this is a very vintage one which can be useful for masculine projects as well. So then the entire designing has taken care of all different requirements, and very thoughtful designing. Now this another paper that you see has a floral background, and there are so many things into it, like a water fountain, stamping, postcard written on it. So there's a lot of stamping effect which makes it complete by itself. So you do not need to do much, you are sorted, you know, with such kind of prints. And again here you can have it into parts and use them. Now this particular print with stack of teacups is very ideal for any kitchen decor project. Like on the other side, there are these elegant elements with space around, and that space enables you to work on the background. Like you can use crackle effect on it and do more stuff on it. You can even have a space to have a message, like a pin-up peg and all, you can attach to it. So in this way, this is very ideal for kitchen decor. So there are designs which even let you work and create backgrounds for yourself if you want. So this is one of a very beautiful print. Now this is again an overall butterfly design, very happy, very cheerful print with smaller butterflies on one side and bigger on the other. So again, you can here cut elements at the same time, the other side you can use it overall for your name boards, for a girls project, like a very shabby chic projects and all, you can make out of these. So again, these have taken care of all styles of crafting in mind. Now, the birds and flowers, I mean, they are anyone's favorite. I mean, here also, you can cut them out. You can, you know, use it in different ways. Like, you know, what attracts me is that I get multiple prints in one package, and that, you know, kind of helps me create various decors. Now, this is a very unique print, one of my favorite. If you see, there are postal stamps in that, some kind of a write-up and the flowers. Now, what is very beautiful here is the way the colors are, the brown and the teal, the red and the green, the way they merge with that little teapot border. It is just amazing. It is one of my favorite and a very versatile one again. So this is the one which is a poppy print, red poppies. I think everyone would love them. This is the one which I've used for my festive platter, and I will show you how I have used the borders and fussy cut elements out of it as well. So this is something which I wanted to share regarding the prints. Now, as I was talking to you, that there are other things that you can do with these is you can use them for embossing, for die cutting. You can even use it in other craft forms, like for card making, scrapbooking, envelopes. You can use these papers for them apart from decoupage. Again, the thickness of the paper, it is helps it sanding. So basically, when you are making coasters, you can sand it off easily, the overhangs. Now, here are some pictures from my earlier projects where I have created 3D effect with the papers. That is again possible because of each thing having two sets in it. And the thickness. Again, these papers can be used for image transfer, as you see here. Now, image transfer is possible again with these papers because of the thickness of the paper. Now, let's come to the tutorial. Here I have a tray from the store. Now, this tray is a little different from the regular one without handles. It has a large side thickness, and that helps you work on the sides. And as I showed you on the back, if you see the detail, it's very good when it comes to contact with water. It is like, you know, there is a border on the back side, so your entire base does not touch the table, and that helps, it gives it a water protection. So what I've started doing, I plan to decoupage it with a poppy, red poppy print. And so accordingly, I am giving the edge of the tray, the painting part I'll be doing first before I come to the paper adhering part. So I'm using a red chalk paint, the salsa red, for giving the border to the tray, a red border to the tray. And then the next thing is the base of the thing. I would want to add some tones of brown to it, again in a very watered down color I'm using, so that I see some kind of grains, because the wood here is a light wood with little grains evident in it, which I wouldn't want to miss out on. So I'm covering it with brown chalk paint again, but that is very thin down and a watered down paint that I'm using. Now, going ahead from here, if you see, the next step that I would be doing is using the paper. So let me just talk about it, as you can see me painting, that I have the poppy print. In poppy print, as you had seen, that there is one overall one from which I have cut borders, and from the other one I have fussy cut out the flower element. So I've cut borders. Now, to cut borders, basically you need to cut exact to the size, and for that I have used a cutting blade, and then I have measured it with scale to size and cut it accordingly. So I have cut out borders for outside and inside, though I do not plan to turn the border all around. Basically, I would be doing it halfway through, because on the half area I want to stencil as well on the sides. Now here you can see me fussy cutting the element which would be adhered on the base of the tray. Now for fussy cutting, you basically need to use scissors with a pointed tip, as you can see me doing here. That helps you go in the depths. Fussy cutting is basically when you cut exactly the shape, and to go into, to have intricate cutting and go deep inside, you need a scissor with a pointed tip. Here, once I fussy cut the entire thing, you will find these scissors are locally available, or you can pick up scissors even from the store that has pointed tip. Now, this fussy cutting is again one very good feature, because the thickness of the paper will not pop out. As you can even see on the screen, that the paper is thin. Any paper which is within 100 GSM is good to go. Now here I have used Deco Magic, that is Decoupage glue. Now this is an amazing product of Itsy Bitsy. Decoupage is done using Deco Magic Decoupage glue. Now how is it different from other glues, the regular glues? Because it is used for adhering, that is one thing that you can see me doing. But apart, it has archival properties, which means that it doesn't let the paper yellow when it is applied as a top coat. It is applied even as a top coat once after giving some 15-20 minutes of drying time after adhering. So it even works as a sealant, making it making the product wipeable. So that is the reason why you should use Decoupage glue. Now the consistency of this glue is very good. It is very good with both if you are working with Decoupage napkins or with papers. And as you can see here, the paper thickness, which I have been very mentioning frequently, here you saw that it easily turned around the curved edges of the tray without, like, you know, kind of jutting out, or with very ease it is flexible on the curved surface. Now the next step after adhering the paper is that, as I mentioned, that I do not want to have paper completely, but I want to have it halfway so that I can stencil. So I decided to use this stencil because it is a festive platter. I have picked up a little ethnic design, and as you've seen, I gave a little blue tones on the base of the tray as well, because when I picked up my stencil colors, I thought this would be very great back as a blue base along with some brown peeping through it. Now if you see the stenciling, I'm doing with tinted metallic paints, the gold and gold shade as of now, and I'm doing it with stencil brush. Using a stencil brush always gives you crisp stenciling, as you can see here. And at the same time, the effect is very wonderful and very easy when you work with stencil brush in a pouncing method. Now after doing the gold stenciling, I thought I should add some copper as well on it, which I did it again. And however, you could do it simultaneously, like a dual stencil work also. Now in order to give a blending effect, as I have used blue on the base, I'm doing some dry brushing with blue on the paper area, and this will give me a more merged and an overall effect. Like, you know, it will bring me oneness, and that is the reason I'm doing that dry brushing with the chalk paint, the blue chalk paint, which I have, the name is Sailing Sky, which I have used on the base. Even in order to give a merged effect, I'm doing the same stencil in bits and parcels on the paper area using the metallic paint, the tinted metallic paint, which is the tawny glitz, the copper color is what I'm using here. And this will kind of make the two areas in oneness. Now having done that is the stenciling bit, I would do some dry brushing with copper in on the edges and on the inside. Now that is kind of like giving a distressed edge. That will give like a completeness to the project and also add depth to the project. Again, the paper edge that is seen on the top, like if you see, there will be a white edge on the top that you can make out, so that also will be hidden by doing this kind of distressing work, which I'm doing on the edges. And I would be doing a bit of copper dry brushing on the base as well, for to make it all look together, for it to all come together. So this distressing the edges is very important, and that adds a lot of depth to the entire project. Now having done that, I will now adhere my fussy cut elements again using the Decoupage Deco Magic glue. It is available in matte and glossy finish. I'm using the matte one here. The choice really depends on what you want as an overall finish. Like adhering, it doesn't matter what you use, but when you apply it as a top coat is when your gloss or matte, your choice you get a finish like that on top. See, this is how my tray looks right now. Now what I need to do is embellish it further and make space. As it is a platter, I want to make space for assembling different things into it. So it's Little Birdie, that is a manufacturing brand of Itsy-Bitsy, has come up with many natural product recently. These include these bell cups, the shola flowers. So I have used them. Now here I am applying the stone texture paste on the bell cups. That will give me an added texture to it along with a natural wooden effect, and I plan to use them in order to put my sweets. Like, it is a platter, it is a Rakhi platter that I have in mind. So then that would kind of carry my sweets, like that those bell cups would be the space for my sweets. Now the stone texture paste again is an amazing product on one of them. If you see, I applied on the base and the other I'm doing it on the top side. Now the stone texture paste dries by itself, and it is ideally applied with palette knife. You can use it with stencil as well, and as it dries, it will adhere to the surface and the natural grains in it will give you a beautiful stone effect. And there are these natural particles in it which dry, and the color also darkens a bit. Now there's a wooden log slice also that I am using, on which I am decoupaging again the fussy cut flower from the decoupage paper. And then I am even applying the top coat on few areas of the decoupage glue. Later I have applied that on the entire tray. The top coat of glue is to be applied only on the paper and not on the stenciled or the painted area. I'm completing my wooden slice with a bit of stenciling and dry brushing. Now further, I'm embellishing the tray using the burlap border. Since I've used some natural products, I wanted to add some natural embellishing. So I have used burlap border and I'm sticking that with the silicone glue. Now again, this is one of my favorite products from the store because it adheres all kind of materials, may it be fabric, may it be metal, may it be any natural material, with ease and instantly, and very easy to use for children as well. I'm adhering the flower in position, and now because it is a platter and with all the natural elements, I wanted to add some kind of texture again. So I've used the craft pellets, the micro ones, and I've used soft gel medium to adhere it. That makes it easy to adhere when you use soft gel medium. It dries clear and at the same time it sticks permanently. So that is the reason why I have used soft gel medium to adhere the craft pellets. I'm adding some to my bell cups also, and that would kind of add some more texture along with the stone texture paste. So this is how it looks, my bell cups, which are to hold my sweets and dry fruits. And I have that potli pouch on which I have done image transfer, and my tea light holder as well, and the wooden slice to hold my Rakhi, and some I have recycled the tea light holders to hold my rice and my kumkum. So that is how my overall elements look, the tray and the different elements together. And then here they go into the platter. If you can see one by one, you can see in the still pictures how they go together. And my beautiful platter is ready for the festive season. Thank you for watching, and do get inspired.